Hi students, I am C. Anuj Jalota. In this video, I introduce you to Paper 5 CA Final Costing Subject, actually known as SCMPE, Strategic Cost Management and Performance Evaluation. Is subject ke andar kya hai, we'll try to see. What are the various topics, we'll try to see that also. Ye subject padhne ke objectives kya hai, we are trying to be seeing that. And if you like this particular subject, what you can do to make your knowledge better, we are going to be seeing that also. So let's start first. This subject is not much connected to your CA Inter costing. In CA Inter, our subject was cost and management accounting. We were concerned with accounting of the cost. But now we are not much interested in accounting of the cost. Businesses don't run by accounting. Businesses run by running the business. Taking proper decisions. That is what I am concerned whenever I am trying to teach this particular subject. Hum log har business ka har ek angle wo dekhne wale hain. Right from the time you purchase raw materials to manufacturing, you send the goods to the wholesalers, retailers, marketing, sales, after sales service, everything we are going to be trying to see. तो इसलिए अगर आप सीए इंटर के अंदर कॉस्टिंग के अंदर बहुत अच्छे नहीं भी थे, इट विल नॉट हैम्पर योर सीए फाइनल का दिस पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट. इट इज नॉट कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ दैट. यस, फ्यू थिंग्स लाइक से स्टैंडर्ड कॉस्टिंग इफ यू नो माइट हेल्प यू, बट देन वी आर स्टिल गोइंग टू बी सीइंग ईच एंड एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम स्क्रैच इटसेल्फ. क्योंकि इंटर के अंदर इट वॉज ऑल अकाउंटिंग, बट नाउ इट इज नो लॉन्गर अकाउंटिंग एज सच. स्ट्रैटेजिक कॉस्ट मैनेजमेंट एंड परफॉर्मेंस इवैल्यूएशन मीन्स व्हाट? स्ट्रैटेजीज. हर बिजनेस को सक्सीड करने के लिए कोई स्ट्रैटेजीज की जरूरत पड़ती है. स्ट्रैटेजीज कैन बी ऑफ मेनी थिंग्स, कि तुम्हारा मार्केटिंग स्ट्रैटेजी क्या होगा, आप लोग का प्राइसिंग स्ट्रैटेजी क्या होगा, आप लोग रॉ मटेरियल्स किधर से खरीदोगे, हाउ टू टैप योर कस्टमर्स, दैट कुड बी अनदर स्ट्रैटेजी. दैट इज फर्स्ट पार्ट. सेकेंड, कॉस्ट मैनेजमेंट. मैनेज योर कॉस्ट इन अ प्रॉपर वे. Ensure that wastes are less. So you'll have some subjects or some particular topics like lean system that tells you how you can try to have proper cost, not high cost. Kabhi kabhi cost kam karne ke chakkar mein quality of your product might going down. Okay, aisa nahi hona chahiye. So your first part is making strategies. Second, manage your cost. And third, performance evaluation. आपकी कंपनी अच्छा कर रही है कि नहीं, हाउ विल यू फाइंड आउट दैट? मैं क्या देखूं ताकि मेरे को पता चले कि कंपनी इज डूइंग गुड? इज इट ओनली प्रॉफिट्स? हम लोग जब एक कंपनी को सिर्फ प्रॉफिट के हिसाब से इवैल्यूएट करते हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इवैल्यूएटिंग अ कंपनी फाइनेंशियली. बट अ कंपनी विच इज फाइनेंशियली स्ट्रॉन्ग टूडे माइट नॉट रिमेन फाइनेंशियली स्ट्रॉन्ग ऑलवेज. नोकिया वॉज अ लीडर एट वन मोमेंट ऑफ टाइम. Very strong company, Finland based company, very strong company. But something they must have done wrong. Might be their R&D was not good. Might be they missed the train by thinking ki smartphones kabhi duniya mein nahi hoenge, touchscreen phones ki koi market nahi hogi. So tab wo log financially to bahut strong the, lekin shayad koi department ke na weak the. So you should know how to evaluate a company. If ever you're going to be having startup of your own, obviously, financially, तो तुम्हारा performance शुरू में अच्छा हो ही नहीं सकता. So other factors will matter. Third, businesses are changing. Try to think, competition is increasing. Forms of businesses are increasing. कितने सारे business दुनिया के अंदर से निकल गए, कितने सारे products जो थे वो निकल गए. Businesses have changed. Top companies at one moment of time are no longer there. General Motors was leader at one moment of time. Today it is not. Sony company was leader in televisions. Today it is not. Something must be changing. Businesses are changing super fast. Technology is coming in, and therefore you have to be evolving every single day. You as a student, you all will understand that whatever you are doing today, tomorrow might not hold good. चीजें ऑटोमेशन की तरफ जा रही हैं. यूरोप जाइए, वहां पे देखिए, अकाउंटेंट्स वो वाला काम नहीं करते जो इंडिया के अंदर कर रहे हैं. वहां पे ऑल एंट्रीज आर पास्ड बाय द सिस्टम्स इटसेल्फ. यू डोंट डू एनीथिंग. सॉफ्टवेयर्स डायरेक्टली बैंक के साथ अपना ईआरपी कनेक्ट करके ऑटोमेटिकली बैलेंस शीट्स एंड पीएनएल अकाउंट्स गेट प्रिपेयर्ड. ओके, सो थिंग्स आर चेंजिंग. टेक्नोलॉजी ऑब्वियसली हैड वेरी ह्यूज इफेक्ट्स ऑन रनिंग ऑफ एवरी बिजनेस. every business today is either using technology or creating technology. Try to think companies like Google, Apple, companies like Microsoft, companies like HP. Now, these companies were nothing much, say 30 years ago. But today, these companies have become so big. These companies almost control the entire database of the entire countries. Cloud softwares have started to come. How businesses are changing, either you can be a company who uses the technology created by somebody else, or obviously you can be a company who creates technologies. Your normal business, dukano wala business, brick and mortar stores are converting into e-commerce. Some company like say Amazon today, worldwide, one of the biggest companies. Their networks are so huge. There are so many parts of such business. Their logistics are so strong. Raw material, ya fir goods jo hain, kahan se aayenge? People shop across the world, goods wahan tak kaise pahunchayein? It's totally different. Brick and mortar stores, matlab jo normal dukane hoti thi, they concentrate on, bhai, goods mil jaye, bik jaye, job is over. But e-commerce is not about that. Businesses are changing. Companies are shifting from push system to pull system. Push system, goods banate raho, stock rakho, kabhi na kabhi bik jayega. Pull system. Pull system, demand aayega, to goods banate hain, why to have stocks? So things are changing. Your some part of the syllabus like just in time system concentrates right on this particular thing only, that how can a company shift from push system to pull system. Decision making has changed. Earlier decision making was very simple kyunki aapke paas data bahut kam hota tha. Aaj ki date mein data gets generated so much every single day. A company like Flipkart, kitna data unke paas hoga of the customers. You have to use that particular data for better decision making. So decision making has changed. Jaisa pehle hota tha, abhi shayad sirf 10 figures nahi hote. Today there are so many customers. Okay, trying to analyze that data is a huge thing. Competition has increased so much. Obviously, try to think, say that in India, car companies, from only Fiat and Maruti, today there are so many. And every company is trying to become number one. Companies like MG, Morris Garage, those guys are launching now electric vehicles. They are trying to compete with Indian companies in the electric vehicle segment. Mahindra is launching the electric vehicle. So things are changing, guys. Portion of your subject is basically designed so that you learn each and every element of business. It is slightly similar to whatever is there in ACCA papers. It's slightly similar to whatever you have at CIMA level also. But old course and new course have this kind of a difference. Here you are trying to learn how to run a business in a proper way. There has to be a way of running your business. Situations change obviously from one business to another, from one year to another, from one day to another day. Try to think in 2015, when say Vodafone was making plans how to become more big in India, there was some other company who was thinking how to destroy Vodafone, and that was Jio. Okay. 2015 se leke 2020 tak, how telephone companies have changed. So many companies have just gone out from the market. Companies like Aircel are no longer even heard of also. Okay. Might be new generations will not even hear of such kind of companies. Kitni sari companies have gone away. Reliance telecommunication by Anil Ambani went away. So situations are changing. Jo aaj true hai, shayad kal true na ho. Science of business is undergoing a lot of changes. And lastly, businesses are becoming complex. I guess you understand the meaning of that, that it is not going to be remaining same. Competition is increasing, technology is coming, everybody wants to be doing good. So businesses to handle is becoming difficult day by day. Now, coming back to your topics of your this particular subject, what ICAI has done, they have divided this entire paper into 12 topics. And you have a 13th one that is of case studies. Now, I say for the first time in the new subject, give you weightage. Weightage of each and every part. So, we have first part over here coming from, this is your section number one. In this section, what you all will be made to understand is strategic cost management and decision making. This approximately carries a weightage of 35 to 40 marks. Now, in this, we are going to be having seven topics. Now, these seven topics are aimed for one thing. That is, the heading tells you that strategic cost management and decision making. So, first thing that you will have is introduction to this particular subject. What is the difference between old thoughts and new thoughts? Earlier, every business had basically one objective, save cost, but now you have the other objective. Till the time you incur cost, you will not even attract the customers. Okay, that we tell you, we teach you in chapter number one, introduction to strategic cost management. Second, modern business environment. In modern business environment, we learn new types of businesses like e-commerce up and so on, how those are playing important role in running everybody's business. Third, lean systems and innovations. This will introduce you to many new techniques like Kaizen costing, like TPM. These are all new techniques which help to save cost, trying to run your machines better, evolve much better. Cost management techniques, whereby how to cut down the cost, your total quality management, just in time, few of these particular topics will start to come as part of this. In cost management for specific sectors, ICAI has given the theory for three of the sectors, agriculture, power and IT sector. Decision making and pricing strategies and decisions. That is your sixth part is decision making. Core decision making situations will be there. You try to decide whatever is best for the company. And pricing decisions, what should be the selling price for your product. I'm just trying to give you an overview, not trying to much describe what is there in each and every chapter, but just an overview. Your second section is all about performance evaluation and control. And obviously the first topic that comes over here is nothing but performance evaluation and control. Now, this is all about new ways of trying to measure the performance. In this chapter, we learn some concepts like balance scorecard, performance prism, performance pyramid, triple bottom line concept, building block model. Then something like economic value added, how to measure performance of a company. Second, in this case, divisional transfer pricing. That's your internal pricing. That is, one department is transferring something to the other department. At what price should the transfer happen so that other guy has some motivation to perform better? Budgetary control, we are trying to make the budgets, but then we have other parts in this particular chapter. What do you mean by feedback system? What do you mean by feed forward system? What is top to down budgets? What are bottom up budgets? Okay, all those things will start to come. What are disadvantages? What is beyond budgeting? That part comes. And then your standard costing part, whereby institute is not now much interested in calculation of variances. They are interested in other aspects. That is how to use that information to make your company better. Now, the last chapter in ICAI's books, that is your chapter number 13, that is case studies part. Now, this case study is going to be your first question in the exam of 20 marks. Plus, there will be small case studies also in the further question paper. So, around 20 to 30 marks, you all can be expecting this. And this covers up your entire portion. They will give you a business problem and they will ask you how to resolve such kind of problems. Now, if you are further interested in running your business, this is one part that will be helping you all much more. This is one part that was never ever there in the old course, is of course there in the new course. Now, if you do like this subject, and I really think most of people who are interested in making good amount of money and who want to be doing their own business would like such kind of situation, because every sum is going to be new for us. Every situation will be new for us that we all have not done. So if you like this subject and want to become expert in this, then following other courses that I recommend, you can go for UK based qualification of ACCA, in which almost entire course is similar to whatever is there in your syllabus. So it might not be an advanced knowledge, but it will be a similar knowledge. First. Second, you can go for CIMA, Chartered Institute of Management Accounts, again a London degree. That will equip you with the top level knowledge that you require to run your business. And concepts like, say, cryptocurrency, all those things will also be coming over there. Apart from that, of course, you can try to do MBA from either from India or from abroad. In India, you can select the best institutes which are there, like IIMs. Apart from that, you can go for, say, the city-wise best colleges also. Like in Mumbai, you have NMIS, then SPGN up and so on. Obviously, best experience is to start your own business. There might be certain failures, but that's okay. Failures are obviously the first part to success also, so that's fine. But there is no better way to learn business than to do it yourself. Khud karoge, obviously you will be able to evolve much better. And my experience with business, now 2002 I became a CA. 2003 I started with a garments manufacturing company with my friends that we all carried on. Apart from that, in 2015, I started with a trekking company. 2016, I started with AJ NeXt. Now, these three types of businesses that I have done, all of them have been totally different. One is dealing with workers. Second is a technological business. Third is core teaching business. Okay. Every business has taught me might be a better way to how to run the next business better. Okay. So teaching is fun when you yourself have experienced all such kind of things. Okay. So apart from teaching this particular subject from last 18 years, my experience with the business has been around the three businesses that I have done as such. Okay. Now, teaching methodology. Now, when you take up costing classes with us, most of the Mumbai students, okay, they all take costing classes with us. ICAI divides entire syllabus into 12 chapters that I have told you all before, plus one more chapter of case studies. What we teach over here, absolutely no formula. Business does not require a formula to run. If there was a formula, everybody will have a successful business. Okay. So we are not going to be learning any single formula. Okay. Just pure common sense, how to run the business, earn money. We are going to be doing that. Okay. Third, what I try to do, once we read a question, I expect that you try that question. There will be a stopwatch or a timer that will be coming on your screen, say 6 minutes. Okay, so in 6 minutes, you're supposed to be cracking that. The time will keep on flowing. And if you can crack it in 6 minutes, honestly, I try to think. In beginning, you might not be able to, but over a period of time, you will be able to beat the timings. In end, your examination paper will go very, very, very good. Okay, so most of people find it tough to complete the paper. You will not find it tough to complete the paper. Everything that you write, we discuss. And any doubts that you all have, obviously those doubts are solved right in the class itself. Be open to new ideas. Many times what happens is that your books, your ICA books might not give you new options. Okay, here we try to discuss all the options. I learn something, you learn something. Okay, but then let's be open to the new businesses which are coming. And lastly, should not be saying that much, but ICA modules for this subject are not very good. They cannot be taken as base for each and everything that will be asked in exams. Okay, I hope that the modules get revised as soon as possible and we come across might be say better questions, better case studies and lesser amount of errors. Currently, there are a lot of errors in the modules also. Okay, so apart from whatever is there in the modules, even if there is a small paragraph about something, I will ensure that those kind of things we will do in detail. So therefore, whatever will come in exam, all those things will be done by us. Okay, now this is all whatever is going to be there in this particular subject. I'm Anuj. I'm a chartered accountant. I was a rank holder at foundation, at final, at TYBCOM level. I'm teaching since 2002 now. And almost every subject in CA curriculum, I have taught myself. But then last 10 years might be, I like this subject much more. So therefore, I thought I'll only continue with this particular subject. In Bombay, everybody does costing with us. It's basically because of the content that we all give to a student. So All the best, guys. In case you will have some queries about this subject, you can post it in the comments below. All the best. I hope you love this particular subject, okay, which is there as CA Final Paper 5 SCMPE. Thank you, guys. Bye.